فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
And scholars, they disparaged, they criticized when a person speaks and he tries to rhyme his words, but he's doing it min tukalluf. You know, he's burdening himself in it. But he's not like that. He rhymes without having to look for it. That's just who he is. And that comes after normal al-mumarasa. When a person reads a lot, their speeches, they become like that. But if it could be changed into وَقَلِيلٌ يَبْقَى فَيَنْفَعُ خَيْرٌ مِنْ كَثِيرٍ يُلْقَى فَيَدْفَعُ. Because the word dafa'a is better in meaning than the word rafa'a. And this is not the place to expand on it. If anyone wants to know later, I can talk to them about it. But it's better to say that. فَخُذْ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْمَعَاقِدِ بِالنَّصِيبِ الْأَكْبَرِ. The author then says to you, take from these chapters which I have placed. بِالنَّصِيبِ, نَصِيب means amount. الْأَكْبَرِ, take a great amount. تَنَلِ الْحَظِّ الْأَوْفَرَ. You will gain a great portion. مِنْ رِيَاضِ الْفُنُونِ وَحَدَائِقِ الْعُلُومِ. You will gain from it. مِنْ رِيَاضِ الْفُنُونِ. رِيَاض means gardens. Gardens of what? الْفُنُونِ, sciences, different sciences. The Sheikh is referring to different sciences as gardens. One time you come into a green garden, you come into another one which is red, and then you come into another different type of garden. And that's what scholars used to call their books, Riyadu As-Salihin, the gardens. That's how they loved it. Are you with me? Bustanul Arifin. Scholars call their books gardens and flowers and stuff like that. روضة العقلاء ونزهة الفضلاء. نزهة. They use these words because it's something that حلاوة في قلوب المؤمنين, sweetness in the hearts of the believers. And the Sheikh said وشجا في حلوق الكفرة والمنافقين. The believer finds joy in knowledge. It's like a garden. When you come to the greenery and you see apples here, pear, dates, different types of fruits on a tree. Does it not look nice? It does. Very good. So the Sheikh is trying to say, you will gain a great portion from these gardens. So you're just going to walk in a garden, take apples. Here it is. The different sciences are the different fruits. وحدائق العلوم. And the gardens, so the word riyad and hadaiq are synonyms. لا مترادف المعاني. وإياك والإخلاد إلى مقالة قوم حجبت قلوبهم وضعفت نفوسهم فزعموا أن هذه الأحوال غلو وتنطع وتشدد غير مقنع فقد ضرب بينهم وبينها بسور له باب باطنه فيه الرحمة وظاهره من قبله العذاب. The Sheikh said, وإياك, and be cautious and stay away from what? الإخلاد. الله أكبر. الإخلاد means leaning. It's to lean. To what? إِلَى مَقَالَةِ قَوْمٍ. Be careful, brothers, pay attention to this. Be careful. Don't lean towards a speech of a people. حُجِبَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, whose hearts are veiled. وَضَعُفَتْ نُفُوسُهُمْ, and their nafs has become weak. People have no aspiration. You can leave your parents to seek knowledge. Really? أخي, just go to university here and study. ضعفاء النفوس, they're called. Don't listen to those people. They say, you're going to leave this bed to a country you don't know, to a people you don't know, to a culture that you don't know, live in the middle of the desert. وإياك, وإياك, brothers. Of what? الإخلاد إلى مقالة قوم حجبت قلوبهم, whose hearts have been placed on it. حجاب, veil. وضعفت نفوسهم, and their nafs is very weak. فزعموا, those individuals have claimed, أن هذه الأحوال غلو وتنطع وتشدد غير مقنع. They looked at the lives of the seer of the Salaf. They came to some halaqat where they heard books of حلي الطالب العلم أما تعظيم العلم by Zarnuji and other books. They heard it being taught and how the Salaf used to seek knowledge and how harsh they were with themselves. And so they came up and they said, أن هذه الأحوال, these situations that you're seeing from the Salaf, these situations which the author is going to bring here, inshallah ta'ala, this is what? It's ghulu, extremism. وَتَنَطُّعٌ وَتَشَدُّدٌ is extremism in exaggeration, and extremism in exceeding the limits and the appropriate amount. That's what it is. The Sheikh saying, don't look at those people's statement. Don't give them any attention. They will even come up to you and say to you, are you going to be a scholar? Who's going to, in this country? Allah, don't you seek knowledge? Don't be a scholar in this country. Don't be a, the man who came to Ansari, man who came to Abdullah ibn Abbas. He said, are you going to be needed with Ansar? You going to be needed with Abu Bakr and Umar and the great noble Sahabas are alive? Did Abu Bakr, did Ibn Abbas give him any attention? He just went. And he sought knowledge. Until the Ansari said what? Huh? He said, كَانَ هَذَا الْفَتَى عَقَلَ مِنِّي. This boy, this young boy was more smarter than I was. He didn't listen to the maqal, the statement of the noble Ansari. So don't listen to those who want to come and destroy and break your dream of becoming a scholar and a person of knowledge. Don't let them, don't accept it from them. Because you know who he's looking at? He's looking at his weak nafs and how pathetic and how low he is. So he's trying to compare you to him, and I'm not like you. That's how you should think of it. I'm not you. I have a dream. وَمَنْ تَكُنِ الْعِلْيَا هِمَّةَ نَفْسِهِ فَكُلُّ الَّذِي يَلْقَى فِيهِ مُحَبَّبُ. Anyone who has higher dreams and high goals in life, every pain I go through before gaining, before my dream, I'm happy with it. I lose my money, I'm in the desert without a family, I'm struggling, I'm suffering, illness hits me, there's no mom to take cook food for me, or I left my wife and children. فَكُلُّ الَّذِي يَلْقَى فِيهِ مُحَبَّبُ. Everything I go through and I endure, I'm happy with it. I can look at my body parts and say, subhanAllah. That day I remember, subhanAllah, I was going to a halaqa. This mark that happened to me. No, it's not literal, I don't mean myself now, I'm just trying to say. You look at your body parts and you start saying, subhanAllah, this was the day I was walking to a dars in Bulugh al-Maram. The teacher was teaching this, subhanAllah, Allahu Akbar. I lost this, I lost that. You can say that, that's a blessing, wallah. Forget the statements of those people. They'll say that to you. أحوال غلو وتنطع وتشدد. All of that is what it is. غير مقنع. They can't convince me that. ولذلك الشيخ صالح عصيمي, one time I remember asking him, I said to him, Shaykh, how did Salaf finish the Quran twice in Ramadan? Shaykh, Ramadan. I've tried everything I had. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i finished the Quran twice in Ramadan a day. 60 times in Ramadan. How? Is this even true? Can it happen? And he said to me, you looked at Shafi'i through yourself. When you're talking about Imam Shafi'i, you're looking at him based on yourself. I said, Jazakallah khairah, that's true. Because I was unable to do it. So I think he couldn't do it. That's exactly many people. When he can't do something, and he can't attain something, or he finds he makes you like him. He makes you like him. Don't listen to him. And he says, that's not convincing. He'll say, Shafi'i memorized the Quran, that's not convincing. The qa'ida is, man jahila shay'an a'adahu wa a'ada ahlahu. When you're ignorant of something, you become what? You start to have hate and enmity towards the thing itself and the ones who are carrying that thing. You're also going to hate them. Look at many people, they will come up to you and they say to you, Usul al-fiqh. Ya akhi, the Mu'tazila place this. Why are you learning this for? Akhi, fikir it. Qala Allah, qala Rasul is enough. Huh? I had people say that. Ya akhi, you're going to memorize that. Hada baytun and this, that, and nahu and sarf and balagha and, you know. Are you really going to give time to that? Then it remind me, أتانا أن سهلا ذم جهلا علوما ليس يعرفهن سهل علوما لو دراها ما قلاها ولكن الرضا بالجهل سهل. It came to me, أتانا أن سهلا ذم جهلا. That سهل. He rebuked and he spoke against a science and a knowledge. علوما لو دراها ما قلاها. A science that if he was to know it, he would not have belittled it, and nor would he have looked down at it. علوما ليس يعرفهن سهل. It's a science that Sahl doesn't know about. And if he was to know it, he would have respected and honored it. وَلَكِنَّ الرِّضَى بِالْجَهْلِ سَهْلُ. But to be ignorant with, to be content with ignorance is easy. Because it doesn't require hard work, does it? It's your natural state. Ignorance is our natural state. And by ignorance is something easy. And the line of poetry makes more benefit, because the first one is talking about Sahl, and the last part of the poetry is talking about easy. Then the author went on to saying, فَقَدْ ضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Don't listen to those people. فَقَدْ ضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ. It has been placed between them. بِسُورِ اللَّهُ بَابْ. A wall. Don't listen to those people. For verily, a wall has been placed between them and knowledge. بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. The ones who are on the other side of it, it's merciful. They're in a state of mercy. بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. And also, on the other side, there is a severe punishment for them. They've been. And وَلِذَلِكَ the jahil, the ignorant one, he is what? He's in عذاب. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, what did he say? Why didn't you ask? إِذَا لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا إِنَّمَا شِفَاءُ الْعِيِّ السُّؤَالِ. Why didn't you ask if you did not know? For verily the cure of ignorance is asking. Cure. That shows you ignorance is a? It's an illness. It's a marad. They're walking around with an illness. They don't know. They're afflicted with an illness. And the cure for them was what? Knowledge. But the knowledge that was their cure, what did they do to it? They're speaking against it. They're belittling it. They're not respecting and honoring it and glorifying it. فَقَدْ ضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ. It has been placed between them. And knowledge, بِسُورٍ a wall. لَهُ بَابٌ. It has a door. بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. In the inner, there's mercy for those who are in it. وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِ الْعَذَابِ. And the other ones who are outside and who are not allowed to be in it are having a severe punishment. And he got this from what? Surah Al-Hadid. When Allah talks about the munafiqeen and the believers. Then the author then says, فَلَيْسَ مَعَ هَؤُلَاءِ. Those weak-hearted individuals who have been placed on their hearts veil. فَلَيْسَ مَعَ هَؤُلَاءِ عَلَىٰ دَعْوَاهُمْ. Those individuals, they have not got with this claim of theirs, which is, يَا أَخِي, forget knowledge. We can't attain it as it is anyways. We're not going to get to the bottom of it anyways. We're in the UK. Who's going to... Nah, okay, listen. Leave this for the scholars. Let's just go to Hyde Park and argue. Let's just go to Hyde Park and just debate. That's what we're going to do. Huh? That's the reality, wallahi, sarahatan. And make that our da'wah. Not that I'm saying it's not a da'wah. That needs tafsil. But to leave off da'wah, speaking of teaching knowledge and learning knowledge, he doesn't want to do it. So those individuals, لَيْسَ مَعَ هَؤُلَاءِ عَلَىٰ دَعْوَاهُمْ. This claim of theirs, they don't have with them مِنْ أَدِلَّةِ الشَّرْعِ مَا يُصَدِّقُهَا. Textual evidences that acknowledge and affirm what they are saying. So it brings us back to the statement of the poet, وَالدَّعَوَى مَا لَمْ يُقِيمَ عَلَيْهَا بَيِّنَاتْ أَصْحَابُهَا أَدْعِيَا. If a claim is not backed up with evidences, then it's just a mere claim. No one's going to really take it into board. The Prophet said, لَوْ يُعْطَ النَّاسَ بِدَعْوَاهُمْ لَدَّعَى رِجَالَ أَمْوَالَ قَوْمٍ. If everybody was given what they claim, then a people, إِرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ, a people would have claimed what? لَدَّعَى رِجَالَ أَمْوَالَ قَوْمٍ وَدِمَاءَهُمْ. A people would have gone out there and started claiming people's money. If proofs were not taken from people, then I would have said, Yunus, that t-shirt you're wearing is mine, give it to me. That hoodie is mine. Sah? But proofs are needed. I'm going to be told, okay, get your receipt. Sah? If it wasn't like everybody would claim everybody's wealth. وَدِمَاءَهُمْ. And their blood. I would have said, or the other, my family member who died in cancer. Yeah, Yunus killed them. Oh, blood money. He killed, I know, he did it. If a claim was taken on board. But the Prophet said, وَلَكِنَّ الْبَيِّنَةُ عَلَى الْمُدَّعِي وَالْيَمِينُ عَلَى مَنْ أَنْكَرْ. So you ask this person, what's your evidence for this? That we should stop learning knowledge and that we're not going to ever be needed. Where do you get this from? Where's this? There's no delil for it. وَالرَّعِيلُ الْأَوَّلُ السَّالِكُ. Sorry, وَلَا مِنْ شَوَاهِدِ الْأَقْدَارِ مَا يُوَثِّقُهَا. Even the universal, worldly signs don't even affirm what they are saying. صح؟ In terms of the worldly, the way the world runs, can you ever say, ya akhi, look, maths, science, doctor, ya akhi, there's no one who's going to ever need you to be a doctor, so let's just leave it. Let's just leave it there. There are real doctors in the NHS. real consultants. Yeah? Can guys be nurses? They can, right? But you want to be a nurse? Who's going to really need you? Yeah? No one would ever say that. So even the Shawahidul Aqdar, the world and the way it runs is not even in agreement with them, in the argument. وَإِنَّمَا هِيَ عُذْرُ الْبَلِيدِ Rather, this is the excuse of the dumb one. The dumbo, huh? In school we say dumbo, right? And that's the kalam of a balid. The word balid comes from the word balada. It's the one who's dim-witted. That is the excuse of the dumb one. He's dumb. Huh? He can't learn. Because he's just dumb. Not that he's got learning difficulties, but he's just dumb. That's his excuse. So why are you going to listen to a dumb person's excuse? To try to take you away from seeking knowledge. Don't listen. وَحُجَّةُ الْعَاجِزِ And it's also the proof of the lazy one. That's his proof all the time. It can't be done. Is it even realistic? I don't think so. That's what you hear from these people. What is it? حُجَّةُ الْعَاجِزِ And there are people out there, brothers, whose job is to demoralize you. Sahih? Have you guys come across it? If you haven't, then you're not really seeking knowledge, are you? Has everyone, huh? I'm Samad, now that you want to go seek knowledge, many people are telling you, what are you doing? Are you right? Sah? Live your life here. You got a nice car, you got a nice lifestyle, stay here. You really want to go to Egypt, the middle of the desert? People say that to you. 10 years later, when you come back, those people are still working in the post office. Not that working at the post office, huh? Or they're working for TfL. Yeah, Transport for London. 5 years later, they're working for TfL. Sah? Sah Abu Bakr? It's a private joke. What that means is, brothers, is those people don't go forward and they don't attain anything. So don't let them crush your dream. Don't. فأين الغلو سوري والتنطع من شيء الوحي شاهده والرعيل الأول سالكه فكل معقد منها ثابت بآية محكمة أو سنة مصدقة أو آثار عن خير القرون الماضية The author then says فأين الغلو Where is this extremism that they're talking about? And this is not only something that people use towards knowledge but they also use it when you start practicing. Yes, extreme. غلو تنطع Why are you going extreme for? That's what they'll say to you. Yaakhi, this is not ghulu. And as I said before, extremism is always understood as to being extravagance. Huh? To go overboard with something, that's the only form of extremism that people have understood. But there's another form, it's called tafriyat. Being lenient too much. Huh? And going short. Is also another form of extreme. Sah? Both of them are ghulu. So the Shaykh is saying, وَأَيْنَ الْغُلُوُ وَالتَّنَطُّعُ Where is this extremism they talk about? In something, مِنْ شَيْءٍ الْوَحْيُ شَهِدُ Something that the revelation is bear witness to it. How can something be ghulu? You have a textual evidence for it. Now that's qa'idah you need to memorize then. Nothing can be extreme if it's textually proven. Underline that point, it's very important that you memorize that. Nothing can be referred to as extreme if you have a textual evidence for it. Is that it? La. The author goes on to say, وَالرَّعِيلُ الْأَوَّلُ سَالِكُهُ And the first generation have tread that path. That can't be extremism. See how powerful that is? The Shaykh has taken all these back to usul and qawa'id which he's understood properly. فَأَيْنَ الْغُلُوَ وَالتَّنَطُّعُ How can this be extreme? And how can this be going overboard? When the what? The revelation, the wahy is in support of this. And it bears witness to it. وَالرَّعِيلِ الْأَوَّلِ سَارِكُ And the first generation have tread on that path. They're the ones who took this. How can this be? Can something Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali did be extreme? Huh? Can't be extreme. Because they were the ones who ran away from extremism. فَكُلُّ مَعْقِدٍ مِنْهَا Each and every one of these chapters that I've placed, ثَابِتٌ بِآيَةٍ مُحْكَمَةٍ It is brought with a verse which is muhkam. What does he mean by a verse which is muhkam? He means a غَيْرُ مَنْسُوخَ It's not abrogated. It's not going to be abrogated. These ayat I'm going to bring you are ayat which are muhkama, not abrogated. And that's the case, it is, as he said. أو سنة مصدقة or a sunnah that testifies to it. I personally would have said وَسُنَّةٌ مُبَيَّنَةٌ The reason is because the sunnah is known as what? Allah uses the word tibyanan. Sah? A sunnah that bears witness to it. And a sunnah that clarifies it. So every chapter that the author is going to bring is ayat which muhkama. Ayat that are not abrogated. A sunnah that are going to bear witness to those verses. They're going to expand on it and not oppose it. أو آثار عن خير القرون الماضية And also, statements and actions of the early generation. And he's taking it from the hadith of the messenger. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ The best generation are my generation and the generation to come after and the generation to come after that. And that's how that is the source in which a person should take their religion. Which is ayat muhkama. Sunnah of the Messenger ﷺ that are established. And death, خَيْرُ الْقُرُونَ أَلْمَاضِيَّةِ The three noble generations. Sahaba, Tabi'een, and the Tabi'u Tabi'een. Because they are the best of generation. The khayr of this ummah is in them. That's why Imam Malik said, لَا يُصْلِحُ آخِرَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ The later generation are not going to be successful إِلَّا بِمَا صَلَحَ بِهِ أَوَّلُهَا Except that which the first generation became successful on. Prosperity that we want to attain, we can't gain it except through how they attained it. Allahu Akbar. Then the author then says, فَإِذَا وَثِقْتَ بِصِدْقِهَا وَعَقَلْتَ خُبَرَهَا وَخَبَرَهَا The Sikh says, فَإِن وَثِقْتَ If you then now trust and you're convinced, بِصِدْقِهَا The truthfulness of what I said. وَعَقَلْتَ And you've come to understand. Aqalta means, fahimta, you've understood and comprehended. Khubaraha wa khabaraha. Khubaraha, if you want, you can place a kasra on the kha. And you can place a dhamma on the kha. You can say khubaraha, or you can say khibaraha. No, sorry. You can place Dhamma on it, or you can place a Fatha on it, sorry. Are you with me? You can say Khubaraha or Khabaraha. And what it means is Ilmu Shay'in, the knowledge of something. Wa Khabaraha, it's news, it's information. فَلَا تَقْعُدْ هِمَّتُكَ بِخُطْبَةِ الْكَسَلِ وَالتَّوَانِي Do not restrict your aspiration. That's why I said himmatuka is the fa'il. Okay, it's the fa'il. فَلَا تَقْعُدْ هِمَّتُكَ Don't narrow and restrict your aspiration. By who? بِخُطْبَةِ الْكَسَلِ وَالتَّوَانِي The sermons of those lazy ones that do lazy sermons. What does he mean by it? He's going to mention it. تَتَسَلَّلُ إِلَيْهَا وَهِيَ تُجَلْجِلُ تَتَسَلْسَلُ means going into. الدخول في الشيء. إِلَيْهَا وَهِيَ تُجَلْجِلُ تُجَلْجِل is to repeat something. Don't listen and restrict yourself, allow yourself to listen to the khutbas of those lazy ones. Who keep continuously going into topics and they keep repeating it by saying هذه أحوال. This is what they keep saying. هذه أحوال من مضى من سلف الأمة وخير الورى فأين الثرى من الثريا. These lazy ones. Huh? They keep saying these narrations and these stories are the affairs of the early generation. These are the noble people. We can't become like that. It's the khutbatu al-kasal wa-tawani. It's the khutbah of the lazy one. He'll tell you, هذه أحوال من مضى من سلف الأمة وخير الورى. When you say to your parents right now, I want to go to Egypt and I want to learn. And Imam Ahmed did that. Ya akhi, wallah, ummi, mom, that's Ahmed. His time was different. These people, they were the best of people, sah? هذه أحوال من مضى. This is the situation of the ones who came. من سلف الأمة وخير الورى. And the best of people. فأين الثرى من الثريا. ثرى is the sand and the dust. ثريا is a star. And it's one of the highest stars. Where is the sand and the dust from the sky? They'll say to you, where do you, the thara, and they're the thuraya. You're not close to these people. So they want to belittle you. Whenever you bring the statement of Imam Malik, the statement of Imam Ahmed, the statement of the Aimmah, they'll say to you, أين الثرى من الثريا؟ هذه أحوال من مضى من سلف الأمة وخير الورى. They want to put your aspiration low, so you don't gain knowledge, so you don't learn. صح؟ The author refutes this concept and this belief. He says, بَلْ مَنْ سَمَتْ نَفْسُهُ. Rather, the person whose soul is high. سَمَتْ سَمَاء عَلَى نَفْسُهُ. The one whose nafs is high. إِلَى مَقَامَاتِهِمْ. His aspiration in it. Sorry. His aspiration is high. His drive is high. To what? إِلَى مَقَامَاتِهِمْ. To their levels. He does not want to go any way below Ibn Abbas. That's his drive. That's what he wants to do. Ibn Mas'ud, who said, مَا مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ أَيْنَ نَزَلَتْ وَفِي مَنْ نَزَلَتْ وَمَتَى نَزَلَتْ. There's not a verse in the Qur'an I know except where it came down and who it came down and when it came down. I know everything about it. He wants to be like that. Every verse in the Qur'an I want to say the same with that Ibn Mas'ud said. He wants to go to that maqamat, that stations. The author then said, أَدْرَكَهَا. You can reach it. Are you there? Muhammad Amin al-Shanqiti rahimahullah, in his biography when I read it, Muhammad Atiyah Salim spoke about it. He said that people said to him, are you going to do tafsir after Jarir Tabari done tafsir? Ibn Kathir did it, Qurtubi did it, Al-Alusi and others did it. What are people going to do with the tafsir of yours now? What is it that they haven't said that you can say? Yeah? Isn't that the case? Ahmad al-Amin al-Shaqiti responded by saying, وَكَمْ تَرَكَ الْأَوَّلُ لِلْآخِرِ. How many have the first generation left for the later generations? There's always room for something to be said. And that's how it is. Scholars have always been doing tafsir. Another scholar comes and he does tafsir. صح? Because the jabs of the Quran doesn't finish number one, and number two, aspirations. Aspiration. So the Shaykh here, when he says, أَدْرَكَهَا, he reaches them by making sure that he works hard. And then the author brings, I ask you a question. هَذِي أَحْوَالُ مَنْ مَضَى. Are you with me, brothers? The word man. أَحْوَالُ مَنْ مَضَى. The word man is mufrad, is a mawsoola. And the ones he's speaking about are, he's talking about who? سلف الأمة. Why is it مفرد? And is it not جمع? One is باعتبار لفظه and one is باعتبار معناه. باعتبار لفظه is that the من is a موصولة and it's connected to مضى, which is a مفرد. And in terms of its meaning, it's connected to the Salaful Ummah. So the ma'na, it is general, is jama'. And in terms of the wording, because it's connected to mada, is mufrad. That's why it's mufrad. بَلْ مَنْ سَمَتْ نَفْسُهُ إِلَى مَقَامَاتِمْ أَدْرَكَهَا. Then he brings the call of Imam al-Shafi'i. And many of the times you see the author does not attribute the lines of poetry to anybody. So we'll try to do that bin Nilal Kareem. This statement is attributed to Imam Shafi'i. He said it. He said, فَتَشَبَّهُ إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ إِنَّ التَّشَبُّهَ بِالْكِرَامِ فَلَاحُ. The author says, فَتَشَبَّهُ. Imitate them. Imitate them. The scholars and the righteous people, imitate them, copy them. Dress like them, act like them. إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ. If you're not from them. If you're not even like them, try to copy them. Dress like them, act like them. إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ. إِنَّ التَّشَبُّهَ. For verily, imitating and mimicking بِالْكِرَامِ, the honorable people, is a falah and is a success itself. Just the fact that you're mimicking them is a success itself. Huh? What is the Shaykh trying to use from this line of poetry? He's trying to use what the usuliyin known as qiyasul aks. If imitating them, copying them, doing what they do is honor, the opposite is true, right? Which is not imitating them, not trying to copy them, is what is not success. It's a state of loss, right? It's like the statement of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, when they came to him, they said, أَيَقْضِي أَحَدُنَا شَهْوَتَهُ. Does one of us fulfill his sexual desires and then he gets a reward for it? The Messenger said, أَرَأَيْتَهَا أَمَا أَرَأَيْتَ لَوْ وَضَعَهَا فِي حَرَامٍ. Do you not see that if he was to do it in haram, for أَنْ يَكُونَ عَلَيْهِ وِزْرٌ, that he will have a sin on it? That's called qiyasul aksi. That in the opposite, if he did it haram, what would happen to him? If he fulfilled his desires in haram, what would happen to him? He would have a sin, right? The Messenger said, alayhi salatu wasalam, the man came to the Prophet, he said, Ya Rasulullah, if I was to does one of us fulfill his desires with his wife, does he get rewarded for it? The Prophet said, yes. What about if he was to do it in haram, would he have gained sin from it? He said, yes. They said, if he does it in halal, then he should gain reward for it. That's called qiyasu al-aksi. This is what the author is trying to do here. He's trying to say that since this line of Imam Shafi'i is saying that imitate and copy the people of knowledge, for verily imitating and copying them is success, the opposite is true. Which is, if you don't copy them, and you don't mimic them, and you don't imitate them, then you're going to what? You're not going to attain success and happiness. So he's refuting those who said, this is the situation of the previous nations, and they are the best of people, then we are the dust and they are the sand, stars, so we shouldn't imitate them. He's refuting that. فَأَشْهِدْ قَلْبَكَ. Then the author says, make it known to your heart, هَذِهِ الْمَعَاقِدَ. Make it known to your heart these chapters. وَتَدَبَّرْ مَنْقُولَهَا وَمَعْقُولَهَا. And ponder on what? On the statements. وَمَعْقُولَهَا. And the rationality behind it. وَاسْتَنْبِطْ مَنْطُوقَهَا وَمَفْهُومَهَا. And extract the direct speech that are in it and the indirect speeches that are in it. Because mantuq means is the statement that the person directly says to you. And the mafhum is what you understand from that statement. So if I tell you to stand up, is mantuq. And not to sit down, is a mafhum. If I tell somebody to stand up, I didn't tell him don't sit down. That's a mafhum. You can take that understanding out of it. So my speech, take out from it the mantuq and the mafhum. Here there's a ta'aqib I have. The mafhum is a lazim that you necessitate from somebody's speech. And according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, لازم المذهب ليس بلازم حتى يلتزم به صاحبه. And this is one of the unique things that the Nusus al-Wahyayn hold. Which is what? The Kitab and the Sunnah are the ones who hold this. The Quran, you can take the mantuq and the mafhum as a hujjah, proof. But the statement of a person, you can't until he accepts it. Sah? If you necessitate an understanding from my speech, you can't hold me account from what necessitates from my speech until I accept it. Like the Asha'ira, when they said Allah, they negated Allah's characteristics. Are you with me? What necessitates from their speech is what? Inkarul Qur'an. That they rejecting the Qur'an. Sah? Can I say to them, la, you're kuffar based on that? La. Because that's not what he intends. It does necessitate from what he's doing. It does. But you can't force him on that lazim that you've necessitated from it. That's why the scholars of Ahl-Sunnah say, لَيَازِمُ الْمَذْهَبُ لَيْسَ بِلَازِمُ. That is not necessary on me. حَتَّى يَلْتَزِمَ بِصَاحِبُ. Until the person accepts and says, exactly. I was trying to reject the Qur'an. That's what I was doing. Did you not get it all along? Then yakfur. Because he now accepted what necessitated from their speech. For example, you enter the house and you say to your mom, I love you. And your dad said, oh, you're trying to say you don't love me. هذا لازم المذهب. صح؟ It could mean that, right? So it's لازم. And the person cannot be held account to a لازم المذهب. So when the author says, استنبط مفهومها ومنطوقها, we accept. Like مفهومها, we might find statements that are مفهوم from his speech that may not be حسن. Are you with me, brothers? Because this is the mu'jiza of the Qur'an only. That the mantuq and the mafhum don't contradict itself. Allahu Akbar. Are you with me, brothers? The mantuq and the mafhum of the Qur'an, both of them are simultaneously going shoulder to shoulder. And they don't contradict itself. That's why anybody who brings any letter of the Qur'an, you can't change it with another letter, because what's being observed here is the mantuq and the mafhum simultaneously. Sah? This is the i'jaz of the Qur'an. Then the author says, فَالْمَبَانِي خَزَائِنُ الْمَعَانِي. فَالْمَبَانِي, the words, are خَزَائِنُ الْمَعَانِي. They are the treasurers, or the holders of the meaning. The words, some scholars they say, فَالْمَبَانِي قَوَالِبُ الْمَعَانِي. Some scholars they say that. Which basically means that words hold the meaning. They're what holds the meaning. Let's do the first chapter, inshallah ta'ala. قال المصنف وفقه الله. Yeah, who's going to read for us? I'm tired now. We have to give somebody. Hey, Yasir? تفضل.
قال المؤلف رحمه وفقه الله تعالى المعقد الأول تطهير وعاء العلم وهو القلب فإن لكل مطلوب وعاء وإن وعاء العلم القلب ووسخ الوعاء يعكره ويغير ما فيه وبحسب طهارة القلب يدخله العلم وإذا ازدادت طهارة ازدادت قابليته للعلم ومثل العلم في القلب كنور المصباح إن صفى زجاجه شعت أنواره وإن لطخت الأوساخ كسفت أنواره.
The author, he starts al-ma'qid al-awwal, the first chapter. وهو القلب, and it is the heart. تطهير وعاء القلب. This chapter is تطهير وعاء القلب. It means to cleanse and clean out the vessel. وعاء means vessel, utensils. The first chapter is clean your heart. Purify it. Pour everything out of it. That's the first thing. Because everything else the author is going to say later is to put some things into your heart, right? Before you put anything into your heart, what do you need? To clean everything out. If I want to have a cup of tea, what do I have to first of all do? Clean the cup. Imagine I've got nice, pure honey. Manuka honey, the real deal. And I got it from Holland and Barrett. Cost a lot of money, brothers. So, but I got it in a cup that's dirty. Would that benefit? Would the taste come? Yeah? Let. So if I then say, oh, the honey, what's happened to the honey and whatnot? Why is it tasting different? Why is it? It's because the cup is dirty. So for knowledge to enter your heart, first of all, clean the heart. Ikhlas and everything is the next step. But clean the heart first, make it pure, clean. So when knowledge is poured into it, it accepts it. The author says, وَهُوَ الْقَلْبُ. The vessel that you need to clean is the heart. فَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَطْلُوبٍ. Every thing that you're trying to attain has a vessel. Look, some people fall into a mistake when they're reading this part of the line, which is فَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَطْلُوبٍ وِعَاءً. صح؟ You can't say وِعَاءً. Even in qira'at, when you're reciting the Quran, you can't say وِعَاءً. You have to say وِعَاءً. صح؟ The reason is because كَيْفِيَةُ النُّطْقُ بِهَا here is other than لُغَةُ الرَّبِيعَة. Rabi'ah, they went against the call of the jumhur of the qurra, the jumhur of the a'immatul lughah, when it came to the pronouncing of the tanween. That's why when you say nisa'a, ma'a, that's how you read it. It's got a tanween on there. The only thing that you, if there's a tanween on it, that you don't have to pronounce, if there's a tanween on a ta' marbuta. إِلَّا أَن تَتَّقُوا مِنْهُمْ تُقَاهُ. It becomes a hat, right? Huh? Other than that, when you read it, you say فَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَطْلُوبٍ وِعَاءً. Because that tanween deserves to be uttered and it deserves to be read. Then the author then says وَإِنَّ وِعَاءَ الْعِلْمِ الْقَلْبُ. The vessel of knowledge is the heart. The place that holds knowledge is the heart. وَوَسَخُ الْوِعَاءِ. And the dirt in that vessel, it taints and it causes harm. يُعَكِرُهُ وَيُغَيِّرُهُ مَا فِيهِ. It changes whatever in it. So this cup, if there's dirt in it, this dirt will cause problems, okay? And it will cause harm. And it also changed the flavor of whatever is poured into there. يُعَكِّرُهُ وَيُغَيِّرُهُ. What's the best translation you've seen for يُعَكِّر? Changes it, harms it? Taints it? Taints it, okay. مَا فِي وَبِحَسَبِ طَهَارَةِ الْقَلْبِ يَدْخُلُهُ الْعِلْمُ. And based on the purity of your heart, knowledge will enter it. Allahu Akbar. Based on your heart, purity. And how pure your heart is, يَدْخُلْهُ الْعِلْمُ. Knowledge will enter your heart. The seed has to have a kasra on it. That's why you have to say بِحَسَبِ طَهَارَةِ الْقَلْبِ. If you say with a kasra, بِحَسَبِ or بِسُكُون, sorry, بِحَسْبِ, with a sukun, then it becomes qadr. Amount. No, it becomes amount here. Hasb, it becomes enough. Yakfi, sufficient. Sah? Bihasabi means amount. Wa bihasabi, the amount of the purity your heart contains, yadkhulu al-ilmu, knowledge will enter it. Wa idha izdadat taharatu, whenever your purity increases, izdadat qabiliyatuhu lil-ilmi, the acceptance of knowledge increases. How clean and how pure your heart becomes, the more knowledge your heart will take. The more dirty your heart is,